this week's edition of Clayton Update on Clayton TV Channel 11. I'm your host, Haley Thornton. Want to see some great quilts, some beautiful watercolors, or some wonderful paintings? Just drop by the Clayton Center during October. The work of three area artists, award-winning quilter Gina Ross of Smithfield, children's book author and illustrator Linda Farrington Wilson of Clayton, and acrylic artist Zoravan of Apex is on display. The quilts are intricate and beautiful. The watercolors will warm your heart, and many of the paintings are dark and mysterious. They will be on display all month. America's first lady of rockabilly, Wanda Jackson, who shocked audiences in the 1950s as the country's first female rock and roll singer and even dated Elvis for a while, is set to roll into Clayton Saturday, October 22nd for a performance at the Clayton Center. The charismatic singer with the playfully suggestive growl to her voice is back in the spotlight after a hit record and new album called appropriately, The Party Ain't Over, a collaboration with White Stripes guitarist and founder Jack White. She was inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame 2 years ago and was awarded the Americana Lifetime Achievement Award last year. The girl is on quite a roll. Bob Dylan, who asked her to record one of his songs on her new album, calls her an atomic bomb in lipstick. Tickets to the 8 p.m. performance are available at the Clayton Center box office, online at theclaytoncenter.com, or by calling 553-1737. Also, check out the story about her on the town's website at townofclaytonnc.org. Clayton artist Jannie Pret and Clayton Visual Arts Vice President Diane Carroll presented Pret's prize-winning poster Flipside to Mayor Jody McLeod and the town of Clayton this week to hang in Town Hall. The poster, which depicts customers talking and relaxing at a local hotspot, won this year's Think Clayton, Think Art poster contest. Mayor McLeod said the work has a romantic feel that seems to capture the spirit of a different era. It brings a hint of Paris to downtown Clayton. The town council has cleared the way for construction of a new medical office complex on NC Highway 42 near Johnston Medical Center. The new complex, to be called Health Park at 42 West, will be built on an 8-acre tract directly across from the hospital. Plans call for 4 single-story buildings totaling 60,000 square feet of professional office space. Town officials are seeking a conceptual artist to be the community's first artist in residence, a position that will take the lead in helping build Clayton's reputation as an arts community. It's not something that a lot of small towns have, but it expresses our commitment to establishing a reputation for Clayton as an arts community, Mayor Jody McLeod said. I'm really excited that we're going to have someone working with us to provide vision and guidance. The mayor said the artist in residence will be depended on to provide vision for a collaboration of art and space in Newtown projects, as well as finding a way to bring out more of the beauty that's already here. But perhaps the position's greatest responsibility will center on working with residents, organizations, and town officials to promote the arts in step with the community's unique values and identity. And don't forget the world premiere of the new comedy film, Whistling Pines, Friday, October 14th at the Clayton Center. The movie is the second by locally based Webster Falls Films and producer Mark Grady and was filmed in Clayton. Several local actors are featured in lead roles, and you will recognize many of the settings or familiar places around town. Maybe you'll even catch a glimpse of yourself walking down the street. And if you already haven't done it, sign up now for Saturday's special computer class for seniors over 55 at the Clayton Community Center on Saturday, October 15th, and learn to use the internet. And one more thing, the town is expecting a big crowd for the open house of the new law enforcement building on Saturday, October 16th. Come on out and take a look at the new modern complex from 2 to 4 p.m. and be sure to see the memorial to the 3 police officers who have lost their life in the line of duty. That's it for this week's edition of Clayton Update. You can get more news by visiting the town's website at townofclaytonnc.org and the town's Facebook site at townofclaytonnc. Thanks for watching. I'm Haley Thornton.